My dear friends, we read from the book of Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9, it says, how to understand the heart of God. To understand the heart of God, God says, first you need to understand the heart of man. Though God in His love has sent His only Son for us, man is not able to receive that love. Though the Lord has shed His blood for us and redeemed us, man is not able to receive that redemption. Why? Because He says, the heart of man deceives man. Heart deceives man. When the heart is not surrendering to the Spirit, when the heart is not led by the Holy Spirit, automatically the heart which doesn't have the Lord is being deceived by the enemy. It is being destroyed by the enemy. And that's why the Lord says, who can understand this heart? This heart which is supposed to give itself to the Lord, instead it has not given to the Lord. It refuses to give it to the Lord. And maybe it is busy and it is not alert to give itself to the Lord. That moment the enemy comes to attack. We know about the great servant of God, Jonah. God called him, gave him a wonderful anointing with one sermon to convert 1.5 lakh of people. I don't think any prophet had received that kind of anointing. But this man did not accept the call of God. He could not give his heart to God. That is the moment the enemy caught him and deceived his heart. When God is calling towards south, he went through north, just opposite direction. Instead of going to Nineveh, he went to Tarsus, opposite direction. The heart is, when it is not given to God, the enemy takes that heart and uses the heart and deceives man. We read in the book of Romans, chapter 1, verse 21 onwards. We will read Romans chapter 1, verse 21 onwards. ఏ హృదయం దేవునికి తన్ను తాను అర్పించలేదో ఆ హృదయమును దుష్టుడు వాడుకుంటాడు. దో గాడ్ న్యూ, దో దే న్యూ, ఆల్ దో దే న్యూ గాడ్, ఓకే పుట్ ద దే బదులుగా హార్ట్, ఆల్ దో ద హార్ట్ న్యూ గాడ్, ఎట్ ద హార్ట్ డిడ్ నాట్ glorify God. See, the heart knew God. They knew God, but they did not glorify. They did not give it to God. So what happened? Okay, it did not honor God. It did not thank God. It not surrender to experience the glory of God. So when the heart did not give itself to the Lord, it lost itself. And darkness filled in its minds and hearts. And so when they have not given their heart to God, how the enemy deceives the heart? The heart tells you are intelligent, you are wise, you can live your life by yourself, you have got everything, you can handle your problems by your power. So by deceiving themselves, say what way? You are wise, you are powerful, you can live by yourself. They thought they are wise, but at the end, without God, they became fools. So when God had invited them to give the glory of God, that is exchanged with the glory of man. So they mad after, who will glorify me? Who will call me good? Who will appreciate me? Who will love me? who will hug me, who will care for me, who will tell you are looking good, you are handsome, you are beautiful, you are powerful, you are so and so. All the praises of the world. When you did not glorify God, the mind was longing for the glory of man, glory of the world. In God, you get full. In him, without God, your part begins to shake. In Tamilam Pasha, they will say, Arai Gudam, Adum. Means when the part who has cut only off, it will make a lot of noise. But when it is full, there is a peace. So that's what happened. Because they did not glorify God, the evil came to deceive them, saying that you are wise, you can handle your life by yourself. They thought they are wise, and they became fools. They thought they have eternal God. They forgot the eternal God, and they got that which is passing away. That which is eternal they lost, and for the cost of holding on that which is passing away. Vellipothuna danni pattukoni nirantaramaina danni var kolpoyar. Praise the Lord. So the heart can be deceived by the enemy. When the heart is not given to God, when the heart is not glorifying God, the enemy takes control of your heart. And that is the sad story of King Saul. We read in 1 Samuel chapter 15, where God is calling him to glorify God. And Saul comes and asks, Lord, can I go for the battle? The Lord says, yes, son, go, I am with you. But remember, the town of Ai is full of black magic and soothsaying. So don't touch that of black magic. You don't need it. Your God will supply more than what you get from that city. That cursed things you don't touch. But the Israelites went, as the Lord said, they conquered, but they took nice goats, nice gold, silver, valuable things. The Lord said to the prophet Samuel, they have rejected me. They have rejected my word. Many people seek God to get something out of God. But very few people seek God for God. Very few come to him and say, Lord, I need you. Most of the people come to God that what they can get out of God. Maybe they can get a blessing. Maybe they can get a prosperity. Maybe they can get a healing. Maybe they can get in their position. Maybe their problem solved. They come to God for the favors. Another word for grace is favor. So many go to God. Very few tell him, Lord, I come for you. I need you. So we find the Lord rejected Saul. The Lord rejected Saul because his heart was gone away. You read the book of Acts, chapter 13, verse 22, read.
When he had removed him, he made David their king. In his testimony about him, he said, I have found David, son of Jesse, to be a man after my heart.
After my heart. Very few people went after the heart of God. They longed for God. Very few went for God. Most of them, they went for something to get out of God.